Now let's move on to the Nano. You know, we shipped the first Nano 3 years ago in 2005. It's only been 3 years. This was our first generation. Then we had our second generation Nano. This was really a beloved product, the metal and the incredible colors. And then we had our third generation product in 2007, putting a much higher resolution display on for video and other things where you really want just a beautiful, gorgeous display. But we have a new iPod Nano for this holiday season. Let me show it to you now. This is it right here. It's really, really beautiful. And it combines the best of both worlds, the portrait aspect ratio that people loved, and the same, exactly the same, super high-res display in portrait mode. And yet, it is the thinnest iPod we've ever made. It is really beautiful. You can see it's an oval shape, and it fits in beautifully, as you can see, with the line. The first and second generation portrait, but exactly the same high-res screen. I happen to have one in my pocket. Let's go ahead and turn the camera on. This is what it looks like here. And let's zoom in on it. Let me just turn it sideways here. You can really see it like this. You can see it like that, what it really looks like. Isn't that cool? Very beautiful. So I think when you actually see one of these things, you're going to just be blown away with how beautiful it is and how thin it is. Okay. So, what are some of the features of this new iPod Nano? Well, a new curved aluminum design. It's got curved glass over the display. The glass actually curves. It's very nice, very durable. It's the thinnest iPod we've ever built. It's got an enhanced user interface with some really nice features. We've taken the accelerometer from the iPhone and the iPod Touch, and we've brought it to the iPod Nano, and it does some wonderful things. And you can actually create Genius playlists right on the Nano itself, even when it's not connected to iTunes. So let's take a look at some of these user interface enhancements. With this high-res display, you can have beautiful, nice, long menus. This is what it's like to look at songs now. We're displaying the albums they come from. And with the accelerometer, you just turn your iPod Nano sideways. You're in cover flow. It's really nice. And then pick a song and go back there. You get full-size album art. Now playing screens. Again, with photos, just turn the Nano to see a photo in landscape mode. Video is fantastic on this high-res display. And another cool thing is you push and hold down the center button, you get a pop-up menu, and you can start a Genius playlist right on the iPod Nano. You can add songs to album on the go. You can browse the album. You can browse the artist, all just by holding that center button down. And this is when you start a Genius playlist. You can see it right on the iPod Nano. You can refresh it, and you can save it for later. It's very, very nice. We have extras that we normally ship, calendar, stopwatch. There's even a voice recording program on, so when it detects a microphone, you can record voice notes to yourself. It's very, very nice, and if you'd like, I'd love to show it to you. So let me just play around with it a little bit. Let's go into music, and let's go into artists here. And we'll pick, let's see. Oops. Pick Beck. And, let's see. Pick a song I like. And so while my music's playing, I can just rotate this sideways, and I'm in cover flow. Back. I got the album. So like over here, and I'm gonna go find Bob Dylan, freewheeling Bob Dylan here. And I think I'll pick Don't Think Twice, It's All Right. Come on. I can hear the songs you say. And now, there I am, listening to that. And I can push down the center button. It ain't no use, sit and wonder why, baby. And I can even start a Genius playlist based on those songs right there. And it's created it for me right on my iPod. There's a Donovan song. Go to the next one. And so it's taken the songs that I have on my iPod and it's made a Genius playlist right on the go. Not connected to iTunes or anything else. Now, one other really cool thing about the accelerometer is we have a new feature called Shake to Shuffle. So just take your iPod, shake it, and I just turned on Shuffle. I didn't really want to tell you I had Dean Martin on my iPod, but if you don't like that song, just shake it and you'll get another one. Isn't that cool? So shake the shuffle. Okay. So let's go back and we'll go to just photos. I just want to show you that too. And let's see. Yeah, Zach Lake. Here's some photos. And again, we can just thumb through the photos. They're beautiful high-res display. And of course, it won't take too long before we get to one in landscape. And again, we just tilt the unit, go to landscape, take a look at some photos there, and you know, back to portrait here. And it just works really, really well. So that's what I wanted to show you on the iPod Nano. So we've got some great, great new features, and we've also got some great battery life, 24 hours for music and 4 hours for video from the thinnest iPod we've ever made. I think that's a real accomplishment. Now, another accomplishment is we want to be just really environmentally sensitive with these products. We ship a lot of them. We're constantly worried about reducing the size of the packaging and the transportation carbon that we spend to move these around the world. But the biggest thing we worry about are the toxics. And we have an environmental checklist we use internally on everything. And I have to say, the new iPods are looking great from this point of view. They're arsenic-free glass, they're BFR-free, they're completely mercury-free, and they're PVC-free, and they're highly recyclable materials, the aluminum and the glass, highly recyclable. So we're really trying our best. There's more we're going to do in the future, but so far, we think these new Nanos are the cleanest, toxic-free iPods we've ever built. Now, there's one thing I haven't really talked about with the new Nanos, which we call nanochromatic. They come in some amazing colors, the best colors we've ever done. Johnny and his team came up with some, just some fantastic colors, and here's what they are. Now, normally they come up with some colors like this, and we pick a few of them. We decided to do all of them. And so we're doing all of these colors in all the models. We have two models. The first one is going to have an entry price of $149 with 8 gigabytes of memory. That's our highest memory we've ever had. And we're going to have a second model with 16 gig at $199. And both of these are shipping out of our factories. The 8 gig should be in stock in the next few days, the 16 gigs, hopefully this weekend, early next week at the latest. So we're really, really happy about this. And we've also got some great accessories that we're announcing today. Of course, we have the requisite armband, which is nice. But we've got some headphones as well. We've got a pair of headphones we're going to be introducing. Now you can say, well, why do you need headphones? Headphones come with the Nano. Well, these headphones have something on the cable that we've borrowed from phones. And it's this little thing that sits on the cable that allows you to pause and play your music. And if you double-click it twice, it goes to the next song. And if you triple-click it, it goes back to the previous song. And we've added volume controls. Volume up and volume down. So you can set the volume, you can go next and previous, and you can go play and pause all right from the headphone cable. And on the back side, we have a microphone, which works beautifully with that voice recording app inside the Nano we saw a few minutes ago. And so right from your headphone cable, you can control your whole Nano. It's really nice. And these headphones will ship for $29 next month. We've also got some new in-ear headphones. And these, we think we finally got these right. They ship with three sets of earbuds, so you can pick exactly the ones that fit your ears. And they've got two drivers each in them, a woofer and a tweeter in each side, which is something you normally don't find until you get pretty expensive headphones. And these headphones are going to sell for $79, and they're going to be available in October. So, the incredible new iPod Nanos. Now, we've made a new ad, and if you'd like to see it, I'd be glad to run it. Yeah? All right, let's run it. That's going to be a lot of fun. So, the new iPod Nanos, catch them this week. They're really, really nice. So let's move on.